today will finally get back the results of this year's FCAT exam.
The scores are coming in a month late. West 2's Jeff Lennox live at the Orange County School Board headquarters. Jeff, what's the holdup here?
Well, the company in charge of grading the FCAT really blaming a variety of different issues here on this subject. And the company's CEO back in mid-June even went as far to blame his own employees. More than a month overdue, NCS Pearson, the company hired by the state to grade the Florida Comprehensive Assessment Test, has a big deadline today. In a meeting back in mid-June, the company promised to have scores from the FCAT back in the hands of school administrators.
We regret that any issues that are caused by the delay in the score reporting, and we certainly understand the importance of the information and the importance of the decisions that are made with the information.
Pearson says today, schools, including those in Central Florida, will have access to individual student scores. Parents and students can see the results starting on July 6th. As for why the scores were late coming in, the company says a new system used to generate the scores is to blame, along with human error.
I have to say, when it comes down to it, there's human foibles and human issues here around how we've understood the customer's requirements and how some of that has been managed internally.
CS Pearson faces thousands of dollars in fines for the late scores. Again, those scores expected out today. We are going to be in contact with the school board and Pearson to find out when those scores come in. And, of course, we'll report that information for you on the air and also InsideWesh.com. Live at Orange County School Headquarters in downtown Orlando, Jeff Lennox, West 2 News.